Coffee person? I mean, really a coffee person. Misha, if so, this is the story you've been waiting for.
New coffee shop just opened up in South Philly, but this one is different. It uses science to perfect the perfect brew. Now, Eyewitness News reporter Justin Finch is live at Function Coffee Labs. We've noticed he's been there a few hours and is talking faster and faster and faster. Good morning, Justin.
I just might have been. I've had a couple shots after all, Jim, Brooke, and of course, special recognition to Misha. We're here with Ross Nickerson. He's starting today's first big brew. And as he does that, we want to note that his fiance and co-founder, Megan McCusker, is out sick today. However, that will not stop us from showing you more of what they do here. Ross is starting today's first big brew. And as he gets that ready, let's show you more of Function Coffee Lab's story.
At the corner of 10th and Carpenter Streets, an experiment.
So we're zeroing the refractometer.
That gadget there measures total dissolved coffee solids, key here engaging coffee flavor.
So is 15 grams of dry coffee going in.
The daily grind at Function Coffee Labs. Research, then record.
Then over time, we can keep track of how the coffee's tasting.
Sample.
Yeah, it's not bad.
And repeat. It's part of what makes Ross Nickerson and Megan McCusker's new coffee house stand out.
Morning, Julian.
A quirk that comes from Ross's pen engineering background.
As a scientist, I basically always see the value in numbers and the value in measuring everything.
Their coffee, handpicked from roasters who source the world's best beans, then Function's fine-tuned grinding and brewing maximizes the natural fruity flavor that you will actually taste. I did.
It should be pretty smooth, not any bitterness.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I can taste it. It almost tastes like there's already sugar in it.
About a year ago, Ross and Megan were across the pond, living in England where Ross was teaching. They dreamed of opening their own coffee shop. The question was where.
Like, is it going to be in Europe? Is it going to be back home?
The orange walnut biscotti taste will come out a lot more.
They chose South Philly. The next choice was the shop's name.
You need coffee to function, but then we were like, actually, well, F of X is really like scientific and mathematical. And
about a minute 45, we're gonna start pouring again.
You know, Ross is definitely into that.
He definitely is into that, a fitting name indeed. And right now here, Ross is starting the closest thing that we can do at home, which is a big drip brew. And Ross, how can we kind of get this same quality at home?
So probably the first most important place to start is to weigh the coffee that you're going to dump into your little drip machine. Yes, it's easy to just use a few tablespoons, but you'll be more accurate, more consistent if you weigh it. Next thing is, once you dump the coffee in, you want to give it a little shake so that the bed of coffee is completely flat in your filter. If it's not flat, if you leave it mounded up, you're gonna get a very uneven extraction, and that will lead to less deliciousness. So let's pop this in here and get the first batch going.
I also want to point out a quick thing that I used to do and will do no longer. Ross says when you grind your beans in the morning, the smaller, rather shorter the window between the grind and the brew will actually impact the taste. Is that right, Ross?
Yes. So because coffee has so many volatile compounds in them that very easily escape from the particles into the air, they effectively go stale very quickly. So the sooner you can start brewing after you grind your coffee, the better.
And keep those beans cold.
Keep them cold. So I wouldn't recommend just putting them in the refrigerator or a freezer in the bag and then take it out, use some coffee, put it back in, because you're going to get moisture in there. So if you really are taking your coffee seriously, I would recommend freezing in pre-weighed sealed containers like this and take out one dose at a time. So each morning take out a little frozen packet. And that will lead to better taste.
All right, Ross, thank you so much. I'm telling you guys, each of these four shots here may all look the same. They all taste very differently. And that's because of this process Ross is doing here. We're at Function Coffee Labs here in Bella Vista. And guys, you've got to get down here as soon as possible. Back into you.